Greetings everyone. It's Friday the 17th of May 2024. We are recording this video shortly after 1 p.m. In the morning we received news from News 24 that the Special Investigating Unit SIU had raided 5 refugee centers across South Africa. This is an article from News 24. It says, I quote, it is understood that the unit is investigating corruption linked to the issuing of asylum and refugee papers to foreign nationals entering South Africa. With the help of the Hawks, the SIU carried out the search and the seizure operations in Gqeberha, that is Eastern Cape, Pretoria in Gauteng, Musina, Limpopo, Durban, KwaZulu-Natal, and the Cape Town, Western Cape, which fall under the Department of Home Affairs. According to the article, News 24 was present at the raid in Marabastad, Pretoria, where more than 60 Home Affairs officials were understood to have been identified as suspects in the investigation. The SIU officials quickly moved into the building and entered offices to ensure that no evidence was destroyed. Home Affairs officials' cell phones were seized and no employees were allowed to leave the premises. SIU boss advocate Ed Motibi and Minister of Home Affairs Aaron Mtsoaledi were also present. In February, News 24 reported that President Cyril Ramaphosa signed a proclamation authorizing a probe into allegations of serious maladministration and corruption spanning 20 years, which led to the issuing of permits and visas, close quote. If you acquired your documents fraudulently, you are in trouble. If you acquired your document not in the official way, if I were to use that phrase, you are in trouble. We know the desperation that people have on documents. In isiNdebele, we say, ukugijima ayisikho kufika. Do not cut corners when it comes to documentation. If you are desperate, as many people are, you run the risk of getting a fake document after paying so much for your document, which turns out to be fake. We've discussed in this platform those that pay huge sums of money for fake documents. Some pay up to 50,000 rands or even more, and it turns out to be fake, right? And we have said in this platform that even if you go to the Department of Home Affairs or someone tells you that they work in the Department of Home Affairs, you go there, you are likely again to be issued with a fake document. We have discussed this in this platform. Comrades always ask us about how to obtain asylum documents. And I've always said that the last time I visited the refugee center was before the issuing of the DZP Documentation Zimbabwe project. When the announcement was made in 2010 that Walters, or those that were holders of asylum documents, could return them and apply for special permits, we shifted our focus. Because we had negotiated and understood that people were applying for asylum documents using them as a permit. And we knew that they were not, the majority of them, from Zimbabwe, that is to say, were not deserving people. They were not seeking protection they were simple using those to work or to run a business or even to start. These are economic migrants. This is why the majority then had to return the asylum documents and applied for special permits. And we know that because of desperation, some will still go want to apply for the asylum documents. In January, when the Department of Home Affairs asked, that was last year in December, asked people to make submissions towards the white paper, we came under attack when we were saying, grant special permits to domestic workers from Zimbabwe. Of course, the white paper does not have that, but that is the position that we took as the African Diaspora Forum together with the Zimbabwe community in South Africa. But the point we are making is, we know the desperation out there. It is better to be insulted for putting a proposal on the table to say, please grant special permits to domestic workers. We take the insults. I'm always insulted. I know I'm going to be insulted for saying this. We take the insults. It is better for us to be insulted than to encourage people to apply for fraudulent documents. The building that collapsed in George, where the number of people that have died of migrant workers, again we raise this question to say, why not consider to grant special permits to migrants that work in the construction industry? Because if they are documented, they will not be exploited in the manner in which they are being exploited. Again, we get insults. It's fine. It's fine. People can insult us on YouTube, insult us. Others, they come to me and say, Comrade Mabena, why are they insulting you? That's fine. We take insults. And we are not afraid of being insulted for putting a proposal on the table, informed by concrete realities. What will not do? And we have stayed away from this, is to be the ones that assisted people to acquire fraudulent documents. That we have refused to do. We will not do that. Insult us for saying grant domestic workers special permits, we'll take insults. Insult us for saying grant those that work in the construction industry, grant them genuine documents. Insult us, we'll take the insults. But we do not want anyone to be granted a fake document, a fake permit, a fake asylum document, a fake refugee status. It is against the law, and we are the last people would want to do such. Indeed, we do negotiate. Sometimes when we sit in negotiations, when we raise these issues in meetings to say, but comrades, why don't you consider this? We are told to go away. We accept. But we have put a proposal. I remember I was speaking to one minister the other day. I was saying, but comrade minister, why don't you consider this? The minister said, look, Comrade Mabena, just go away. We can't listen to this proposal. That is fine. It's fine to be turned down. But at least we are putting a proposal that any document that is granted, it must be genuine. It must not be fake. That's why maybe some of us were very poor, because we don't do and we don't encourage people to do or to acquire fake documents. Please stay away from acquiring fake documents. We'll continue to engage And we'll continue to receive insults. Insults don't kill us, right? Because we're putting a proposal. And the insults, we're not scared of them. But what we would not want to happen is for the SIU to come to our offices to arrest us. Can you imagine? I'm not being arrested. Executive Director of the African Diaspora Forum, Chairman of the Zimbabwe Committee in South Africa, arrested for facilitating the issuing of fake documents. We don't want to do such. Please write in the comment section, like this video, subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you're on TikTok, please do follow us. Otherwise, enjoy your weekend. Goodbye.